Hi everyone. Do you like my Christmas scene? My screensaver? Let's see if I can even it out. There you go. Pretty cool, huh? So again, these are on YouTube under screensaver. There's a little elf walking around there. They're on the bridge. So cute. And light Christmas music. So I went to the Dollar Tree today and they haven't raised their prices yet. So everything's still a dollar. And I needed hand lotion and that's all I needed. But I ended up with, you know, bags and bags and bags. So first of all, I bought these at Aldi's. So these are graham crackers with cinnamon. I thought that the cinnamon would help adhere the frosting to the graham crackers when my grandchildren come over and we do our annual gingerbread houses. And so for the candy I chose, there are lots more candy, Mike and Ike's and the Sour Patch. And these flip pretzels and those Trolley Evil Twins. They're just kind of clear, like gummy candies. And then Airheads. So we have Airheads for the gingerbread houses. Pretzels, maybe for the roof, and the Sour Patch Kids to go all over, and the Mike and Ike's. So that's a good variety. I bought more in my last house, so I have a whole bunch. And the next thing, I'm not organized. Oh, speaking of Christmas, I love how they wrap it. This mug, it says, "I'm dreaming of a white Christmas." I thought that was so cute. It matches my blanket from Victoria's Secret. And I like how it's open right here. I don't like the closed mugs where they get smaller because they tend to like drip and you drool, and you need the open, wider mouth mugs. So that's a good mug. Are they running out by your stores? Because this one, I think there were only two left of this one. We got that and let's see, some beauty products. Oh, so you guys. Well, first I'll show you the plates. So I make Christmas dinner for everyone. I have 9 grandchildren, so we need paper plates for the kids. So I thought these were so cute with 3 snowmen and the trees in the background. And then his little ornament. How cute is that? And you get 14, which is a good value for a dollar. And then this one is the Santa Claus, 14 as well. I love his little present and I love that tree. And my son dresses up for Santa every year. We bought a costume from Amazon, amazing costume with boots and everything. Okay, and then, well, we might as well do the, so I found these paper straws. There's 20 paper straws. I like these for hot chocolate. I make smoothies. And they're paper, but they're like solid. You can see the, so there's like the blue stripe and the stars. And then the red, what's on there? Some gold little emblem. And this reminded me of Christmas trees, this one. But yeah, these are super cute. So I thought that was a good value, 20 for a dollar. And then these are a must have. Oh, wait, no, I'm not done with that yet. Look at Godiva chocolate at the Dollar Tree. Can you believe it? Wow. So this is dark chocolate ganache heart. So that would be maybe $4 at a department store. You know how when you go check out at the department store, you're buying your cosmetics or whatever, and they have the little stand of chocolate. It's usually $4 or $5. So yeah, I would grab these. Wouldn't it be cute to like do a mug and put some different Godiva chocolates? I haven't found the chocolate spoons yet, but these with some tissue paper wrapped. Yeah, I would do that. That would be a good gift. Maybe some hot cocoa in there. Okay, so you guys, these are the best invention ever. These, if you haven't tried these, you need to run and get some. So all you do, it's a makeup vanishing towel. So I'm gonna open one up. So I bought six. So I bought six. And all you do is wet the towel and it takes off all your makeup, even your mascara, everything. And it looks soft, see that? And then it's a circle. And then you just wet it with, I use warm water, and then you just take it. Takes all your makeup off without using any soap. So honestly, you guys need to try this. Yeah. And then you just throw it in the washing machine and then it's good to go. I've had mine now. I only bought one like an idiot. So I've had mine now and I have to keep washing it. Like, luckily I do my laundry every day. There's never anything on the floor. I know. That's why my channel is called Cap Clean. Because I'm clean. I clean. That's what I do. I love cleaning and organizing and throwing things away and donating things and... Okay, let's see what we have now. So, my daughter's getting headaches lately, and I get a migraine once in a while. And this is, it's called Relief, Aches and Pains Tension Relief Concentrated Mineral Bath Soak. Powerful therapeutic blend for body strain and stress, sore, tired feet, and on-the-go relief. Epsom salt, menthol, juniper. So you just pour these in your bath and then you get that steam. Well, if you take a hot bath, you know, it's aromatherapy for your bath. So that's a good deal. These are new. New to me. I've never seen these before. Have you guys? And so my daughter called me and she said she needed a serum. She wanted a tea tree serum, but I couldn't find it. So I've got her... found this serum. This is hibiscus rose facial serum. And yeah, so she uses this. You know, these don't have any parabens. I don't know if this one does, I can't read it, but most of them don't that I've researched. And that's good. Can you see it? It's kind of there. And this is a 1 ounce. And then I found this. It's called Overnight Detox Cream, Bamboo and Rose Water. And this is a cream for your face. There. So she's going to try that. And then I found Vaseline Cocoa Glow. You put it all over your body as a moisturizer and it makes your body glow, it says. And this is a brand name, so let's see. So it has one of those things on it. So, and I have really dry skin and it's winter here, so I'm always like washing my hands dry, so I need all the moisture I can get. And then look what I found. This is called a loofah soap. I thought that was phenomenal. Do you see the loofah inside there? Yeah, they had purple and they had another color too and clear, but I like this orange one. It looks like an orange is in there. That's the loofah. So I can't wait to try that. Have any of you ever tried it? Let me know. Comment down below. And then, so my hair has been so dry lately. So I bought a hair mask. So I just use these as my conditioner. So that's it. Every time I wash my hair, I use this hair mask. So this says no breaks hair mask, mango butter, castor seed oil. And this is by Bolero. So let's smell it. It has one of these on it, but that's okay. Smells really fresh. Really mango-y, fresh. It smells really good. So that's that. And this is, I would say, this is 5 ounces, 5 full ounces. I would say that would be good for about 6. I use a lot. I use a whole glob of conditioner. So I would get 6 washes out of this. 6 conditioning treatments out of this. And then we found hand cream. There's a glare. Let's see. So this is pomegranate, primrose, and pomegranate. Nourish and hydrate. So there's 2 in here. Yeah, primrose and pomegranate. Again, I look for parabens. I don't like to use parabens on my body. Parabens are bad for you. Bad for your body. And your skin is your biggest organ, so be careful what you put on it. But yeah, these are cute. A little gift set for $1. I thought that was cute. This would be a great stocking stuffer. So would this. So would this. So would this. So would this. All these. This would be good in a gift basket. Like, you could do a gift basket with this, these, and the hand cream. Yeah, that would be a cute gift basket. And let's see, what else did we get? Literally, I just got back from the store. And I wanted to show you guys because I have to give some of this away to my daughter. So look at these puzzles. These are wooden puzzles. Look at wooden puzzles for $1. I can't even believe it. So this is the numbers, and look at how cute. Up to 10, all different colors, stars. Very cute for a little kid. Here's the alphabet. How cute is that? Yeah. These are expensive on Amazon. And then Old MacDonald Had a Farm, right? Doesn't that remind you of that? With the sheep. What is that? A pig. Looks like a hippo, doesn't it? A little bit. But it's a pig. And then the horse. And the chicken. And then the barn. So cute. And then we found this. Last but not least, right? Look at this one. Clean like a man. Yeah. This is kind of a gay gift, huh? So, new and improved housekeeping for men. Let's see. I'll read you a couple of tips. What? Wait, let's see. Okay, cleaning windows. Cleaning windows and other glass. I'll just read you a little bit of it. It's funny. I like cleaning windows, mirrors, glass, top coffee tables, and the like, because the end result is such a pleasure to behold. Yes. And it's easy and fun to turn filmy, smudged windows and glass into sparkling, clean, streak-free, crystal clear surfaces. Yes. how to. Ready? Spray on Windex or an ammonia and water solution from a spray bottle. Wipe off with cotton cloths or paper towels. Repeat if any dust smudges or film remains. A tip. For a finishing touch, spray on one more light spritz for your solution and wipe with your driest, cleanest cotton cloth. Clean windows from the top down. Clean large windows in quadrants, one area at a time instead of the entire window, which is exactly what I do. You'll do a more thorough, streak-free job. Don't use newsprint. It leaves a filmy residue on windows and the ink blackens your hands. Yeah, come on. Who uses newspaper? I mean, I've heard of it, but no. It's dirty. Makes me sneeze. When I read the paper, I sneeze. Okay, let's see. That's fun. Oh, here's drawers. How to clean a drawer. If you have one or more drawers filled with small items, you can either empty the drawer and vacuum it with your small brush attachment or leave the items inside and attach a nylon stocking to the vacuum hose nozzle with a rubber band. Good idea. Then you don't suck up all your small items. Dirt and small debris will be sucked into the nylon surface, and then you can brush it off over a wastebasket. Just make sure the nylon isn't in active rotation of your wife's or girlfriend's wardrobe. I would just say empty the drawer out and then vacuum it, because once you turn the vacuum off, and because the nylon is covering what's coming into the vacuum, so it'll be sticking to the, as long as the vacuum keeps going, and then you have to bring it over to the garbage, but I don't like that tip. Yeah. Let's see, what else? Getting down and dirty, that's the chapter. This chapter covers the big three cleaning tasks: vacuuming, dusting, and cleaning windows and glass. That rhymed. I wonder if he did that on purpose. Which represent most of the house cleaning chores you'll have to tackle. A basic cleaning kit. Windex, a disinfectant cleaner like Lysol, all-purpose cleaner like Formula 409, Pledge or Enda, soft scrub, feather duster, cotton cloth, multi-purpose scrubbing brushes, one or two small sponges, a whisk broom, a small dustpan, old toothbrush, rubber gloves. Have close at hand a long handled broom, Swiffer or Ready Mop, vacuum cleaner, vacuum hose, nozzle attachment, iPod with headphones. Squeegee, rubber gloves, plunger, small foam rubber mat, and an iPod. Aha. That's the book. It's fun reading these little tip books when you're just sitting around, or put in your car when you're waiting for someone to come out of the grocery store if you're sitting there for an hour like I did today. I waited a lot in the car. Yeah. So this would have been nice. Okay, everyone, that's it. Let me know if you tried. Oh, try to find these for yourself. These would be good stocking stuffers in your travel bag. There's no liquid. Yeah, amazing. Okay, Merry Christmas. Cute, right? Cute. Bye, you guys.